हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग स्टैंडर्ड 8 एंड वेलकम टू टुडेज वीडियो। वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 6 इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज, दैट इज नॉन फाइनाइट वर्ब्स। ओके, नॉन फाइनाइट वर्ब्स वी आर गोइंग टू डू स्टूडेंट्स। यू नो द नॉन फाइनाइट वर्ब इज ए वर्ब दैट डज नॉट फंक्शन एज द प्रेडिकेट वर्ब इन अ क्लॉज और इन अ सेंटेंस। दैट मीन्स व्हाट? इट डज नॉट फंक्शन एज द प्रेडिकेट वर्ब, इट डज नॉट वर्क एज द प्रेडिकेट वर्ब, और वी कैन से it does not work or it does not function as the predicate verb in a sentence or a clause. Okay, and some infinite verbs are used sometimes. You can see in case of past and participles, past and present, past participles or present participles forms. Okay, so they are also not governed by the any tense, numbers or any persons. Okay, see here, two type of sentences are written, 1 2 3 1 2 3. See sings. Okay, see sings. See is a subject, sing is what? Predicate, and this is a predicate verb, right? Predicate verb. So this verb function as the predicate verb in that sentence. Okay, so here say these are the finite verbs. Finite, he walks, I went, so these are finite verbs, right? Now let's shift into the another case. Now here sentence, okay, see here, the doctor attended the injured man. Okay, the doctor attended. Okay, this is the verb which shows the sentence. The doctor attended. Okay, and the injured man, injured word, this word here, it does not work as the predicate verb, right, in this sentence. So that is in the form of past tense, it is true, but the sentence or the meaning of the sentence or tense of the sentence is qualified by this verb. Okay, attended. So injured, we can take injured as a non-finite verb. Non-finite. Okay, similarly in the second case, the crying child wanted me. Crying. Okay, is it a sentence? Is what? Is this what representing or qualifying this sentence as a tense or whatever? No. Right? So as per the definition, it is also non-finite. Okay. Next one is, she is fond of swimming. She is fond of swimming. Okay. Now she is fond of whatever. Okay, now here is word given, swimming. This swimming is a what? This is an what? Adjective, right? So this word also is not working for the working as a predicate verb. Okay, so we say this is also non-finite. In this way, we will see again some more sentences. Okay, here you will notice that each and every discussion will be followed by the or goes on the definitions. Okay, goes on the definitions of non-finite verbs. Okay, but some of the points that we have to remember that we will discuss over here. Okay, over here. Okay, so let me erase the board. I'm discussing. Okay. So next we will see what are the kinds of non-finite. There are three kinds of non-finite verbs. First one is gerunds, second one is infinitives, and third one is participles. Okay. So the gerund words, you know, that gerund means it is in the form of given will be what?
ing
verb or verb. Verb plus ing. Okay? Infinitives. Infinitives will be in 2 plus verb. We know that. Participles. Participles are of two types that we will discuss later. Now see, gerund. Gerund, it is an ing verb words. Okay? And that is used as the, it functions as a noun. Right? Suppose, see the sentence, we say, do you like singing? Do you like singing? Okay. And next sentence saying, selling is my favorite sport. Okay. See, in these two sentences. Now, do you like singing? This is what? This is the word complementary used. Sing plus ing. Okay? Here, selling. Sell plus ing. Okay? So, it is also a what? Gerund. Right? Using as a noun. So, this is infinitive. Or non-finite verb. Okay? So, these are the gerunds. And in case of infinitives, that you will see two. Okay, the sentence like you can see to read is good for mind. Okay, I try hard to understand. I will say I try hard to understand. Here also we will say what? I try hard. This is my sentence. What? To understand. This is to plus understand verb. So it is also non-finite. Right. Now we will see in which cases we can use the infinitives, gerunds and etc. In the sentence, there are actually six positions where you can use the gerunds. First position is subject. See the sentence. Swimming pleases everybody or everyone. Okay. Next sentence is singing is pleasing. Okay. Third sentence is, that is, he was punished. Punished for what? Now for smoking in a public place. Okay. Next sentence. She enjoys listening to music. Swimming pleases everyone. Okay. What is the position of the word swimming? It is a gerund. Verb plus ing. Here, it is the position of the word is what? Subject. In the subject position, it is written. Right. Singing is pleasing. Okay. Now, you see here, pleasing. Okay. The word saying pleasing. It is what? This is the complement position. complement position of verb. Okay, of verb we can say. Next one is he was punished by the he was punished for smoking in a public place. Okay, he was punished. Subject, verb, object, whatever. Okay, this is the sentence. For smoking in a public place. For smoking. Okay, see this. This is what? Object position. Object position. Right? She enjoys listening to music. Right? She enjoys listening to music. Here also object position. But what? What does he enjoy? Listening music. So in this position we can say transitive. Object of transitive. Okay, object of transitive. Transitive. So object of transitive. Again, I like eating chocolate. This is also object of transitive. Object of transitive. Okay, so in this way we can see where the gerunds, the position of gerunds can be taken, okay, and how we will decide whether it is a finite or non-finite. Okay, next we will come to the infinitives. Infinitives and infinitives act as a noun, it may act as an adjective, it may act as adverb. Okay, so it is usually made up of 2 plus 1. Okay, let us discuss some sentence. We will be more clear about the infinitives. Then we will go into the participles. Okay, how? See, I am writing some sentence on the board. See, 2 read is good for mind. Okay. I don't have time to eat. I don't have time to eat. I try hard. To understand. Okay. See, in the three sentence. Here, to read is good for mind. Okay. To read. This one, right? Next one. These are infinitives. To eat and to understand. Okay. See, to read is a good for mind. Right? So, to read, this is used where? In place of noun. Okay. I do not have time to eat. Okay. I do not have time to eat. I do not have time. To what? To eat. If this is written in the adjective position, or it is saying adjective as, right. Next one is, I try hard to understand. What? Understand. I try hard to understand, right. This understand is used as what? Adverb. Okay. So you will see that in case of infinitives or to verb, they are used as noun, adjective or adverb. Okay. Next, there are some use of infinitives. Okay. Infinitives can be used after most of the modal verbs. Right? Right? He must marry now. After verbs of sense perceptions. Right? I heard. her crying in the next room. Okay, I saw the moon shines in the night sky. After the expressions, these are the positions. Next, after the expression, had better, would rather, okay, would sooner, nothing but, cannot but, etc. We will say, you had better admit your mistakes. You admit your mistake. So here you see, you had better, right? Better admit your mistake. Okay. These are the rules given in the books. You can see yourself in the book. Okay. Another thing is, after the verb to let or to have, let me sit here. Okay. Or let me help you solve this problem. Okay. So let or sit. Okay. They are also let me sit here. We can say let and sit. Okay. These are also imperatives. Right. In case of imperative sentence, in case of where is let? Let me help you. Let me help. So let and help. Okay. Solving this problem or whatever. Participles, a few things. Participles may be of two types. It is of two types. One is present, another is past. Okay. In case of present participle, that is verb plus ing or ing word. Right? In case of past participle, it may ended with ed, D, T, N, okay, the word or the participle word, okay. So this sentence or these words you must notice in the sentences. We say present participles. The sleeping cat is brown, and the barking dog is not bite. Barking dog
seldom
doesn't bite. Okay, barking dog does not bite. So in this case, that is. Barking dog, present participle, okay. Similarly, we say the sleeping cat is brown. Okay. Next is nobody likes burnt bread. Likes burnt bread. See the word here. We are our notice. We will notice this word sleeping. Okay, this is what in the form ing. So means this is participle. Okay, present participle. And this one burnt past participle. Right. In this order given, in this way, okay, you can do the exercise. And moreover, if you are getting problems, everything is there in the chapter, and as I discussed, you can look into them. Okay, do all the problems, question answer will be sent soon. Thank you, see you in the next video.